Hello again, people. Yep, it's another video on BoomBoxDeluxe's channel. Now, what we got there up in front of the camera is that three-way adapter device again. And on the worktop around it, we've got some 2.5mm squared there cable. It is twin in earth, and what I'm obviously going to do is whip off that outer sheath and use the cores to wire that up. But in twin and earth cable, the earthing conductor is slightly thinner than the main live and neutral conductors. Okay, I've got a thing that's like 1mm or something. This twin and earth cable is 2.5mm. Okay, so 2.5mm, that is, I think, 24 amps. Okay, these are only 16 amp sockets on here, so that cable will be more than adequate for taking the power. Okay, what I'm going to do with that is I'm going to have the power coming in from our plug there, because I've customized it, I've swapped these two around, coming in from the plug. Okay, all three conductors are going to come from there up to here, out of there, into this one, and then from there all the way down. And if I've got enough cable left, I want to bring all three conductors from there back up to the plug again. Okay, so we've got like a little ring circuit inside there, sort of thing. Okay, if I manage to succeed in doing that and getting all those wires in there like that, for each conductor in there, there will be an effective cross-sectional area of 5mm squared. Okay, which would be a bit overkill, given that 224s will be 48 amps, and that's only a 16 amp plug on there. But given what happened to that before I pulled it apart, it was getting hot. So I'd rather overdo it than underdo it, okay? Yes, that's what I want to do. There's 3 meters of cable there. I probably won't get all of that in there, okay, given how confined it is in there, but it's better to have too much than not enough. Okay, that's what I say. Okay, it's that good old rule again, you know. If it's too long, you can shorten it. If it's too short, you're stuffed and you've got to start again. So I've made sure I've got basically too much cable, and that will see the job through to the end. Now, because that earthing conductor inside that is thinner, I'm going to whip that out, do away with it, and replace that with a bit of stranded 6491X to 2.5mm cross-sectional area again. Okay, hopefully these terminals on these will take two of 2.5mm stranded. Okay, if not, I'm a bit stuffed and I might just have to basically use a solid conductor, which has got a either a black or a red color code on it, and then just put a bit of greeny yellow tape around it to define it as earth conductor instead. Okay, so what I'm going to do now for 4 minutes is we're going to have all these accessories off of that, and we'll have a look around inside. That in there is a couple of screws in there. We're just going to whip that off. That's the plug. I'm going to take every accessory off because they've got to come off anyway for wiring up, and so that I can negotiate and wrangle those cables in there, because that cable in there is actually for what you'd bury inside a wall. Okay, it's not flexible. So I've got a feeling getting that wire in there is going to be a bit of a challenge, but hey-ho. So that's the plug off. Remove the plug. Let's get the socket off. You can see there's not much space in there. And yeah, so 2 screws in that one. And what I want to do when I get this wired up is I want to give this a right proper testing. and see if anything on it gets hot. Okay. Given the way I'm going to wire it up, and each socket is going to have an effective cross-sectional area of 5mm squared, I don't think it's going to get hot. So a little bit later on, in the name of science, we'll give this a proper beating. Okay, and see how it deals with it. So I want to, basically overdo it. Okay, I know each socket's only 16 amps, but I want to push, say, 20 amps through each socket and see how it deals with it. And if it takes 20 amps all day long, then, if it takes 20 amps for the test, then it's going to take 16 amps all day long and keep on trucking without getting hot. Because, yeah, if you basically put on, say, a 10 amp load for, say, the duration of 0.2 of a kilowatt hour and the socket's getting hot, that's not right, is it? So I've got all our accessories off there. There's our what looks like a plumbing fitting now. Okay, and I've got to wrangle some solid stranded, that's probably two different things, isn't it? Solid conductor, that's what I was looking for. A solid conductor, 2.5mm squared cable. Again, it's going to be coming in from that one, going to about there, and then going up to that one. Coming out of there, going back down to about there, and then into this one. Out of there, coming all the way down to this one. And then if there's enough space left in there, from that one, back up to the plug. Okay? So I've got to do that with the live conductor, the neutral one, and the earth one. Okay, all of that in there, and we'll see how it goes. Hopefully that 3 meter length of twin and earth there is more than adequate. And yeah, but like I say, that earth conductor in that's got to come out, because it's less than 2.5mm squared. And generally speaking, that's perfectly acceptable like that, because it doesn't carry any current normally. But under a fault condition, it will do for the amount of time it takes to operate a circuit breaker or pop a fuse. Okay, so for 8 minutes, people, thanks for watching.